So today we're going to have a look at permissions templates inside openSUSE 11.2. But this would be more or less the same no matter what version of SUSE you were looking at, whether it's Enterprise or openSUSE. So the first step is just to have a look at what can be set through the YaST utility. So we go into YaST and drop down to Security, and then open up the Local Security dialog. So there's a whole load of settings that can be made directly through the right-hand dialog, but if we navigate through to miscellaneous settings, then we can see that there's this setting here for file permissions, and we can set it to easy, secure, or paranoid. The default setting is easy, as you can see, and that's good where you're using the workstation as a desktop or laptop machine, it's not a server. If we have a look though at the command line, with what's happening behind the scene, if I go through and look in the USR bin directory for files that have the set user ID bit, we can see that there'll be quite a few files, half a dozen or so, or probably 12 or so. So find USR bin minus perm plus 4000. So all of these files here have the SUID bit set. So when they run with the privileges of the user, not the current user, so the privileges of the user owner. Again, if we look in the bin directory, we can see things like the SU command, the ping command, all have the set user ID bit. Where these changes are made are through a configuration file, etc sysconfig security. So if we open up the sysconfig security file, if we jump down to permission underscore security, we can see it's currently set to easy. But this new file here, local, they didn't even tell us about within the wizard. So we're going to change it to the top level of security, paranoid. And we'll save the change. Now just writing to this file isn't going to do anything. So again, if I go through and have a look at what files there are. So if I just go lsetc permstar, we can see we've got the permissions easy, paranoid, secure, local, the permissions.d directory, and a permissions file. As I say though, just setting the change won't do anything. We have to run a command called suseconfig. You'll see very often when you go through and have a look, when you exit out of YaST, it will run through the suseconfig to apply your changes through to the file system or whatever. So you can see that everything is the same in the USR bin directory. So we'll now run suseconfig. So it's a mixed case command, so just be a little bit careful on it. The suseconfig minus minus module space permissions. And the output you'll see on the screen is that it's changing a bucket load of file permissions because we've changed from the easy to the paranoid setting. Now when we run our find command, we'll see that we don't have any files in USR bin with the set user ID bit. So if we want, let's say, some customizations to this, we will write to the permissions.local file. It's often the case the .local file is a customization file for your own system. So we can say we want people to be able to run the password command. So we're going to add in USR bin password. User accounts are stored in the etc password file. Passwords are stored in the shadow file, and by default, only the root user can write to the shadow file. So I'm adding in the user root, the group owner shadow, and the permissions to be 4755. We'll also allow users to run the su command. So we're putting in bin su. This file needs to be owned by root and group owned by root. And again, the same permissions, 4755. Once we're ready, we save the change. Apply suseconfig. Here, there's less changes. It's only the two files that need to be changed because we're only customizing the current settings with those that we have in our local file. And again, run the find command, and we can see that USR bin password has the 4000 permission included. And again, look at it in the bin and again we see bin su. It's quite different from our original output where we saw quite a few files had it set. Of course, I'm using this as a desktop, so I'm going to change the settings back to easy. So paranoid through to easy. Your starting point, though, in very many cases on a server, especially if it's just going to be like an Oracle server or a DHCP server, a DNS server, is to start out with the paranoid security. A lot of administrators, as you could imagine, would say, oh, I'm not paranoid. But really, it is the best starting point. And this is for system files, not necessarily your own files. So you can see now, having set it back, we're back at the standard permissions. Hope this has been useful.